Christmas lights and decorations, hear the carols and the bells. Deeper than tradition, it's a celebration of the story that we tell.
Thank you. sky, telling everyone Jesus Christ.
Just to say the word Christmas is to stir our senses. We smell fresh-cut evergreens, cookies baking in the kitchen. We see a string of Christmas cards parading across the mantel from fens far, far away, and the glow of candles through a frosted windowpane. We hear children's laughter, whispered secrets, ringing bells. To say the word Christmas is to relive those wonderful times we've shared with people we love. Like the family ritual of picking out just the right tree, or the neighborhood caroling party, or the Christmas dinner our church served to the homeless every year. To say the word Christmas is to feel our hearts turning back to the faces and places, the small ceremonies and events that make up our own special memories, the memories we unpack every year with the ornaments and decorations, and polish them up until they shine, and enjoy them all over again.
Yeah. Living in thy name, he gave
knows where such happenings. I had never loved anyone but Mary, and now she was to be my wife. I remember looking into her quiet, gentle face the day we were betrothed and thinking, nothing could ever come between us now. We had faith and love and a future that stretched out before us like a river of promise. Then she came to me one day and told me in that direct way of hers that she was going to have a baby that wasn't mine. The river of promise turned to a desert of despair. Mary assured me that the baby was sent from God. But how could I believe that, and how was I to deal with that? God help me, I prayed. And that night he told me in a dream, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for what is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. From that day forth, I have been assured that the baby is from God, and now I can only rest in the goodness of the Lord.
Be still and know. Sometimes I wonder if it's the same for everyone. If each one of us can look back on some event in our lives which radically changed things. For me, it's so easy. There was a night in my life so amazing, I couldn't forget it, even if I tried. It started in such an ordinary way. My brother Nathan, my friend Seth, and I were watching my father's sheep, something we did almost every evening. I remember Nathan was bragging, telling some outlandish story about rescuing a lamb from some ferocious beast. That's when I first started to notice the sky growing brighter. The others didn't see it at first. Nathan just kept on talking. Then, suddenly, standing right in front of us was this enormous man, glowing like a star. Although none of us had ever seen an angel, somehow we knew he was one. We were so terrified, we couldn't say a thing. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Today in David City, a baby boy is born. He is Christ the Lord." Then in a flash, the sky was filled with hundreds of angels singing and glorifying God. I won't forget that incredible sound if I live 1,000 years. It was a night of miracles.
Thank you. Oh,
same child who was born in Bethlehem grew up to be a man who was crucified on a cross and raised from the dead. He is alive today, bringing new life to everyday people, continually calling each of us to be part of his family.
Even though Christmas was always one of my favorite holidays, every year after I'd get all the presents wrapped and everything done, I felt like something was missing. Then I remember the year that my mama died, and I was so lonely. My little daughter, Maddie, who was 3 at the time, said, "Mama, I'll help you put up the manger scene." While we were putting it up, I had to laugh. She asked the funniest question. She held up the little Christ porcelain figure and said, "Mama, is this the real Jesus?" You know what? Later, after I tucked Maddie in bed, went back out to the living room, and I sat and I looked at that manger, and I felt like I needed to pray. And I said, "Lord, you know what? Maddie's right. I treat you about like that little porcelain figure. Oh, I get you out once a year, get all sentimental, and I put you back on the shelf for another year. Lord, I never let you be who you want to be in my life. I need that so much right now. Will you come into my heart? Will you show me the way to be your child?" That was it. Wasn't a very eloquent prayer, but he heard it, and he answered it, and it changed more than Christmas. It changed everything.
Knowing you love me, knowing you. was the cantata, the musical, to do one thing, and that is to point to Jesus Christ. This is the first time I've heard the cantata. I try not to listen so that I can hear it as well. But with the outstanding phrase that I kept hearing over and over, my precious Jesus is more than an heirloom to me. My dear friend, Jesus Christ is the only way to salvation. The only way. What they've sung for us tonight is to help us to understand that. There are no other roads. Only the road that comes is the road that Jesus has come for as a baby. But that baby that was born in the manger had one specific goal. That was the cross, more than martyrdom. This Savior died that you and I might have life. That's what we're here for, to share with you and to tell you and let you know that Christ is the way and the truth and the life. The choir has done it so well tonight, and we appreciate that. I don't know, maybe there's somebody here this Sunday night that needs Jesus as their Savior, and you're not clear on how to do that. May I just tell you that it's as simple as ABC. A, admit that you need Him. B, believe that He can save you from your sins. And C, confess your sins. That's the ABCs. But it's more important that you do it. We can understand in our head, but it has to come by our heart. I trust that tonight's performance to you was more than just a performance. That's reality. Thanks, choir, for sharing your ministry and your voices with us. And giving to us salvation's message. Let's stand together, please. Lord Jesus, on this Sunday evening, we thank you for this great choir and what they have given to us and how they have shared